In this video, we will learn about one of the boosting models, CatBoost, and implement it through coding. The name of the CatBoost model is derived from the words category and boosting. It is an excellent boosting algorithm for handling categorical features without explicit pre-processing like one-hot encoding, making it suitable for both classification and regression tasks. In particular, the CatBoost model has unique features such as ordered boosting and ordered target encoding. First, let me explain ordered boosting used in the CatBoost model. In traditional boosting algorithms, when building the model, each new tree model uses the entire data set, including the target values. This can lead to overfitting, as the model may memorize the training data rather than generalize from it. In CatBoost, multiple permutations of the data set are created and they are used to build the model. Each instance only uses the information from previous instances in the permutation, and the final model aggregates the results of these multiple permutations. This process is called ordered boosting, which prevents overfitting, thus helping it generalize better. CatBoost creates multiple permutations of the dataset for training. Let's assume that we generate two permutations from the original dataset. The first permutation consists of 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, and 4, 5, 6. In this first permutation, the model is trained as follows. The first data point, 1, 2, 3, is used to create the initial model. The second data point, 2, 3, 4, is used to update the model based on the information from the first data point. The third data point, 3, 4, 5, is used to update the model based on the information from the previous two data points. Finally, the last data point, 4, 5, 6, is used to update the model based on the information from all the previous data points. The second permutation is trained in the same manner. After that, the results of the models trained on each permutation are combined to build the final model. Next, I will explain ordered target encoding used in CatBoost. Ordered target encoding is a method used in CatBoost to handle categorical features during the training process. This technique captures the relationship between categorical features and the target variable, while reducing the risk of target leakage. To briefly explain, target leakage refers to a premature exposure of the target during the training process. When converting categorical values to their mean target values, there is a risk that target information may leak into the training data. If the target values are included in the training data, it may lead to high accuracy on the training data, but poor predictions on the test data. Sure, let's explain ordered target encoding in CatBoost, with an example where there are three categories of color, red, green, yellow, and a binary target variable. The dataset with the encoded color feature would look like this. In ordered target encoding, the categorical variable is replaced by the mean of the corresponding target values. For the first data point, the global mean of the target values is used. For subsequent data points, the mean of the previous target values for that category is used. For example, the first red value is replaced by the global mean of 0.6. The second red is replaced by the mean of the previous red value, which is 1. The third red is replaced by the mean of the previous two red values, both of which have target values of 1. So the mean is 1. Similarly, the first green value is replaced by the global mean of 0.6. The second green is replaced by the mean of the previous green value, which is 0. In this way, the categorical data is encoded into numerical form. Let's take a look at one of the features of the CatBoost model called categorical feature combination. Categorical feature combination is one of the particularly useful features in CatBoost. It refers to the technique of automatically creating new features by combining existing categorical features. This is done to capture the interactions between categorical features, better represent the data, and improve the model's performance. The process does not necessarily involve identifying redundant categorical features to merge them into a single variable. Instead, it focuses on creating additional features that represent combinations of the original categorical features. For example, if you have two categorical features, color and size, CatBoost can combine these two features to create a new feature. This new feature, such as color size, assigns values to each unique combination of color and size. These combined features can enhance the model's performance. This slide displays the screen for coding the CatBoost model. You can find the Jupyter Notebook file on GitHub, where you can download it and execute it directly. Similar to previous AI models, we first import necessary libraries such as NumPy, pandas, and the train test split library. Then we load the Excel dataset. After assigning X and Y variables, we split the dataset into training and testing data, typically using an 80 and 20 ratio. To perform a classification task using the CatBoost model, you start by importing the CatBoost classifier library. Next, you set the hyperparameters for the CatBoost classifier algorithm, such as the number of iterations and the learning rate. CatBoost uses its own internal data structure called pool to handle datasets. You then train the model using the training data. As a result, when you calculate the accuracy on the training data, it is 95.8%. You also observe a similar accuracy when applying the model to the testing data. You can create a simple code using a for loop to check whether the actual breed matches the predicted breed. As shown in this slide, the code will display true if the actual and predicted values match, and false if they do not. Additionally, based on the obtained results, you can calculate precision, recall, and F1 score values. You can also generate a confusion matrix. Additionally, you can use the get feature importance command to visualize the importance of the features. In this case, it shows that the width of the petal has the greatest impact on classifying the iris flower.